गुड मॉर्निंग. इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 7. इन दैट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. वी हैव सीन द डिफरेंट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक फिजिकल स्टेट, देन द हार्डनेस, ब्रिटलनेस, लस्टर, कंडक्शन ऑफ हीट, कंडक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, मेल्टिंग एंड बॉइलिंग पॉइंट एंड डेंसिटी. ओके, सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स वी हैव स्टडीड. Now the next part is metalloids. Some elements such as arsenic, that is As, silicon Si, germanium Ge, antimony Sb, have properties which are intermediate between metals and non-metals. So these elements like arsenic, silicon, germanium, antimony, this shows the property of metals and non-metals too. Okay. So such elements are called metalloids. Metalloids means the elements which shows the properties of metals and non-metals both. So they are called as metalloids, and the examples are arsenic, silicon, germanium, antimony. These are the elements which shows properties of metals and non-metals, so they are called as metalloids. Okay, so these are the elements like arsenic, silicon, germanium, antimony. They are metalloids. Why? Because they shows both the properties of metals and non-metals. They are intermediate between metals and non-metals. So such elements are called as metalloids. So this is about metalloids. In the previous part, we have studied about metals and non-metals, and this is metalloids. Now we'll see the chemical properties of metals. In the previous session, we have studied about physical properties of metals and non-metals. Now we'll see the chemical properties of metals. Okay, so in the chemical properties of metal, the first one is electronic configuration. Electronic configuration is the basis of chemical behavior of elements. Now we'll see the different metals and their electronic configuration. Majority of metals have up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell. Yes, these we have studied. So as you can see here in the table, we can see the different metals like sodium, Na, magnesium, Mg, and aluminium, that is Al. Okay, so the atomic number is given and the electronic configuration is given. Electronic configuration you have studied in lesson number 5, right? So atomic number is given, you can write down electronic configuration. So the atomic number for sodium is 11. So what is the electronic configuration? As you can see here, 2, 8, 1, and magnesium 2, 8, 2, and aluminium is 2, 8, 3, right? So this is the electronic configuration of different metals. From this electronic configuration, as you can see here, majority of metals have up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell. So in the sodium, how many electrons are there in the outermost shell? As you can see here, only 1 electron. And in magnesium, how many electrons are there in the outermost shell? 2 electrons. And in the aluminium, there are 3 electrons in the outermost shell. Okay, so this is about electronic configuration. Chemical properties of metal, in that first property is electronic configuration. So majority of metals have up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell, and the examples are given, that is sodium, magnesium, and aluminium. What is the atomic number for sodium? 11. So what is the electronic configuration? 2, 8, 1. Then magnesium atomic number is 12. So electronic configuration is 2, 8, 2. Aluminium atomic number is 13. So the electronic configuration is 2, 8, 3. So majority of metals have up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell. So this is the electronic configuration. This is the chemical property of metal. Now we'll see the next property. Yes, now the second property, formation of ions. First property we have seen, that is electronic configuration. Now the second one is formation of ions. Metals have a tendency to lose their valence electrons to form positively charged ions, that is cations. These also we have studied previously. Okay, metals have a tendency to lose their valence electron to form positively charged ion, that is cation. Now as you can see here, the examples are given, that is sodium, magnesium, and aluminium. Okay, as you can see here in the outermost shell, how many electrons are there in sodium? That is 1 electron. So to complete its octet state, sodium will lose its 1 electron, right? So as you can see here, this is arrow, Na plus plus 1 electron, minus. Yes, it will lose its one electron. So sodium, and here it is sodium ion. Okay. So metals have a tendency to lose their valence electron to form positively charged ion, that is cation. Okay. So this is sodium. It will form sodium ion, where it will lose its one electron from the outermost shell. Same for magnesium also. Now it will lose, how many electrons are there in the outermost shell? For magnesium, there are 2 electrons. So it will lose its 2 electrons to form magnesium ion. Okay, this is magnesium Mg, and it will lose its 2 electrons to form magnesium ion. As you can see here, Mg plus plus, right? Now, same for aluminium. Aluminium, how many electrons are there in the outermost shell? There are 3 electrons. So it will lose its 3 electrons to form aluminium ion. So metals have a tendency to lose their valence electrons to form positively charged ion, that is cations. Okay, so as you can see here, there are 3 examples are given. Sodium, it will lose its 1 electron to form sodium ion. Magnesium, it will lose its 2 electrons, 2 valence electrons to form magnesium ion. And aluminium, it will lose its 3 electrons to form aluminium ion. So this is the second property, a second chemical property of metal, that is formation of ions. So what you will write down in this, metals have a tendency to lose their valence electrons to form positively charged ions, that is cations. Okay, hope you are clear with this. And what we are written here, that also we will see once again. See, as you can see here, this is sodium Na, arrow Na plus plus 1 electron minus. It will lose its 1 electron to form cation. Again magnesium, here it is arrow Mg plus plus, here it will lose its 2 electrons. Why? Because in the outermost shell, in the magnesium, there are 2 electrons, right? So it will lose its 2 electrons, and here it is Mg plus plus, as you can see here. Then aluminium, here in between you will write down arrow, this is Al plus 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 3 times. Why? It will lose its 3 electrons to form aluminium ion, that is cation. Okay. So this is about formation of ions, the second chemical property of metals. The first property we have seen, that is electronic configuration, and the second property, that is formation of ions. Metals have a tendency to lose their valence electrons to form positively charged ion, that is cations. Okay, so sodium, it will lose its 1 electron, magnesium will lose its 2 electrons, and aluminium will lose its 3 electrons from the outermost shell. Okay, hope you are clear with the second property. Now we'll move to the next part, that is reaction with oxygen. Now when the metals combine with oxygen to form their oxides, when any metal it reacts with oxygen, it will form metal oxide. Okay, so as you can see here, this is metal. When it reacts with oxygen, it will form metal oxide. Okay, the metal oxides are basic in nature. Metal oxide reacts with an acid to form salt and water. But the metal oxides, they are basic in nature. When they react with acid, they form salt and water. As you can see, a metal oxide when react with acid, it forms salt plus water. Okay, hope you are clear with the third property, third chemical property. What is the third chemical property? Reaction with oxygen. When the metals combine with oxygen to form their oxides, they form their oxides. Okay, when the metals react with oxygen, they form their oxides. And when the metal oxides, they are basic in nature, so when they react with acid, they form salt and water. Okay, this is the third property, third chemical property of metal. The first one is electronic configuration, second one is formation of ion, and the third one is reaction with oxygen. So what you will write in reaction with oxygen? When the metals react with oxygen, it will form metal oxides. And metal oxides are basic in nature, so when they react with acid, they form salt and water. Now, the next property is reaction with acid. Okay, so take dilute hydrochloric acid in a test tube, that is HCl, hydrochloric acid. Then add zinc dust to it. Take a glowing splinter near the mouth of the tube. Observe the glowing splinter, you will notice some sound coming out from it. Most of the metals react with dilute acids to form metal salts, while hydrogen gas is released. So when the metals react with dilute acid, then it gets salt plus hydrogen gas. So most of the metals react with dilute acids to form metal salts, while hydrogen gases release. So when the metals are react with dilute acid, then it forms salt plus hydrogen gas. Okay, so this is the fourth property of chemical property of metals, reaction with acid. When metals react with dilute acid, it forms salt plus hydrogen gas. Okay, hope you are clear with the fourth property. Okay, and the above one, this is the experiment has shown. When we will take hydrochloric acid in a test tube, the dilute hydrochloric acid in a test tube, then we will add zinc dust to it. We will then take a glowing splinter near the mouth of the tube. What you will observe, you will notice the sound coming out from it. Most of the metals react with dilute acids to form metal salts, while hydrogen gases release. So this is the experiment which shows that when the metals react with dilute acids, they form metal salts and they release the hydrogen gas. And this is the reaction down. As you can see, a metal plus dilute acid, when the metal reacts with dilute acid, it gives us salt plus hydrogen gas. Okay, so this is the fourth chemical property. The first one is electronic configuration. Then the second one which we have seen, that is formation of ions. And the third one which we have seen, that is reaction with oxygen. And the next, that is reaction with acid. Now the next one is reaction with water. Most metals do not show any observable and fast reaction with cold water. But some metals like sodium and potassium react with cold water to produce their hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Most of the metals do not show any observable and fast reaction with cold water. But some of the metals like sodium and potassium react with cold water to produce their hydroxides and hydrogen gas. Magnesium metal requires steam to give similar reaction. And magnesium metal also requires steam to give similar reaction. So most of the metals do not show any reaction with cold water, but some metals like sodium and potassium, when they react with cold water, they produce hydroxide and hydrogen gas. And magnesium metal requires steam to give similar reaction. So this is about reaction with water. I hope you are clear with all the chemical properties of metals. So till now we have seen the different properties, chemical properties of metals. The first one is electronic configuration, second one is formation of ions, third one is reaction with oxygen, fourth one is reaction with acid, and the fifth one is reaction with water. So these are the different chemical properties of metals. Okay, in electronic configuration we have seen most of the metals have up to 3 electrons in their outermost shell. We have seen the example like sodium, magnesium, aluminium. In sodium there is only 1 electron in the outermost shell. In magnesium there are 2 electrons, and in aluminium there are 3 electrons in the outermost shell. Now we have seen the formation of ions. Metals lose their valence electron to form positive ion, that is cation. Then the next one, that is reaction with oxygen. When the metal reacts with oxygen, they form metal oxides. But the metal oxides are basic in nature. So when they react with acid, they form salt plus water. Fourth one is reaction with acid. When the metals react with dilute acid, they form salt and hydrogen gas. Salt plus hydrogen gas. And the last one is reaction with water. Most of the metals do not show any observable reaction or fast reaction with the cold water, but the metals like sodium and potassium, when they react with cold water, they produce their hydroxides and hydrogen gas. So this is about chemical properties of metals. There are different chemical properties of metals like electronic configuration, formation of ions, reaction with oxygen, reaction with acid, and reaction with water. So in the next session we will start with chemical properties of non-metals. So today we'll stop till here. Thank you so much.